I'm in New York, which means I have to stop by gCreate, the home of really large 3D printed things and 3D printers. I have a problem with my OpenRC build. The axle had to print in three pieces. They have a machine that can do it in one. Let's go check it out. I'm Joel. This is 3D Printing Nerd. Three different pieced axles. Oh, I gotta redo that. Dang it, three different pieces. Well, in New York, I had to stop by gCreate. They said they had a solution for printing my axle in three pieces. Hey, Gordon.
Hey, Joel. How you doing?
Doing really great. So I see this large machine, and I had to print my OpenRC axle in three pieces because even on a gMax build plate, it wouldn't fit. This is a little larger. Can you talk about it?
Yeah, sure. We saw your video, so we figured we have a large printer. We actually built our gMax Big, actually. It's an in-house printer, but we built it, and we can print your axle all in one part now.
That's insane. Yeah. And just looking at it, it's crazy to think that such a large piece at home wouldn't fit. Now would fit. Can you talk about how you're printing it? What are the settings and material?
Yeah, sure. It's actually funny enough, we actually have room in the edge too, so if you want to go bigger in the future. No, but we're printing at about 207 degrees Celsius. It's a Matterhackers bill or pro PLA.
Pro PLA,
Yep. So about a 25% infill, triangular infill.
Four perimeters, three top, four bottom, all that kind of stuff. Yeah.
We actually add a lot of times for larger prints too, we'll add these kind of elephant's feet in the corners just to make sure it sticks well.
Oh,
and
okay.
They stick great. Yeah.
And this is just acrylic, right? This is not heated.
Acrylic plates on top of this really thick aluminum bed carriage. Custom for sure, but...
Oh, it's huge. Oh, I love this. Well, and right next door, you've got it looks like something else cool printing.
Yeah. Well,
what's this?
Because we're printing an axle, we figured why not print a car rim too.
Is it an OpenRC rim?
It's not quite yet. We probably could transfer it, but I designed this many years ago. We've been dying to try it again. So we had some of the Matterhackers NylonX, the carbon fiber nylon.
Okay.
So we figured what a perfect print for it.
And this is going to be just a rim in the end?
Yeah.
Is that it right there?
Oh, yeah. So eventually it will be just the rim for this.
Oh. Yeah. And you'll have to print a tire right?
Of course. We're figuring, this is just obviously a TPU tire. We want to do an airless TPU tire next. And because of the size of the rim, we can make it as large as we want. So
you can go huge with this.
That'd be great.
And this is, I see you're using supports. So on a nylon material, using supports can be kind of tricky because it sticks so well to itself. How do you know that's going to release?
We're curious. It's actually our first test, really, funny enough. With the NylonX, so we figured why not go for something that has support and a good size object. So
I think with the CF embedded in the nylon, I think it might help with the stiffness with regards to the supports breaking
through.
That's
our hope, yeah.
That's what I'm hoping.
But it's gonna be great. It's about 60% through now, so I guess we'll find out shortly.
It'll be done soon. What else you got to show me?
Great, actually there's a couple other things, but Anna can actually show them to you if you want to check them out over here.
Sure.
Great.
Hi, Anna.
Hey, Joel, how's it going?
Great. Gordon said something awesome was going on over here. Can you talk about this?
Yeah, sure. So this is a bridge torture test that we're conducting on the gMax. It is about 19 and a half hours in and only maybe 15% done. ultimately, this is going to be about 20 inches tall, and it's going to have over 5,800 individual bridges.
That's insane.
Yeah.
Is there something special that you have to do to be able to print this?
I mean, you really just want to dial in the retraction settings. I think that we dialed this in about 1 millimeter, and we're using really good filament. We're really happy with the Matterhackers Pro Series.
Okay.
So we're printing that at about 200C at the moment. So yeah, and cooling.
Jeez, how much filament is this going to use when it's all done?
Ultimately, actually, less than a spool.
Less than a spool?
Mm-hmm.
I guess it's mostly open space.
Yep.
But this is incredible, and this is a great showcase of why 3D printing is fantastic, because I don't think any other manufacturing method could make a 20-inch tall, massive open-air cube like this.
Yeah, it's true. This is something that you would probably not get injection molded.
Will it be strong at the end? Will someone be able to hold this, or do you have to just place it on a shelf?
No, absolutely. It's definitely meant to be held and looked around and played with, so we're going to be bringing it to MRF.
Oh, you will?
Yep.
Oh, I look forward to seeing that. Wow, well, thank you, Anna.
Yeah,
see
thanks for coming
MRF.
By. See ya.
A big thanks for gCreate for letting us stop by and take a look at three different machines. That bridge test is awesome. That rim is going to be cool in the NylonX, and I can't wait to play with that axle that's been printing in one piece when I'm at MRF. But for now, we got to get going. A big thanks to everybody who watched this far. If you want to support what I do, there's a bunch of links down in the description you can tickle. Those will directly benefit the channel and make me smile 10% more each day. But finally, don't forget to hug each other more, because I love you guys, as always. High five.